Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info.
Scientists using the Green Bank Telescope have observed what they describe as a river of neutral hydrogen streaming into the galaxy NGC 6946. The researchers conclude that this tenuous filament of gas is providing the necessary fuel for the high rate of star formation seen in the spiral galaxy. The lead author of a study in the Astrophysical Journal states, "We knew that the fuel for star formation had to come from somewhere. So far, however, we've detected only about 10% of what would be necessary to explain what we observe in many galaxies." What does the Electric Universe tell us about this so-called river of hydrogen in deep space?
In an article in Science Daily titled "River of Hydrogen Flowing Through Space Observed," it's reported that astronomer D.J. Pisano from West Virginia University has discovered what could be a never-before-seen river of hydrogen flowing through space. Now, here we come upon a great problem in modern science, and that is the use of inappropriate words or terms which conjure up images that confuse everyone. How exactly do you have a river flowing through deep space? A river normally has banks or something to constrain it to form a long sinuous channel. Here we have a long sinuous channel of hydrogen, but there are no river banks to hold it in. And that comes down to the next problem of magnetism. Astronomers acknowledge magnetism because they can measure it in deep space, but they have no explanation for why it exists there or why it exists in the forms that are seen. Meanwhile, we have plasma cosmology, which has been around for decades now and is recognized by the IEEE, but which astronomers studiously ignore. Plasma cosmology explains why the magnetism is there, why there are filaments of gas in deep space, and how that comes together to form a galaxy. All of these questions have been answered, both theoretically and by experiment, by the plasma cosmologists, but it's as if it's never happened. The article goes on, "This very faint, very tenuous filament of gas is streaming into the nearby galaxy NGC 6946 and may help explain how certain spiral galaxies keep up their steady pace of star formation." Dr. Pisano from West Virginia says, "We knew that the fuel for star formation had to come from somewhere. So far, however, we've detected only about 10% of what would be necessary to explain what we observe in many galaxies. A leading theory is that rivers of hydrogen, known as cold flows, may be ferrying hydrogen through intergalactic space, clandestinely fueling star formation. But this tenuous hydrogen has been simply too diffuse to detect until now." Once again, if we return to the plasma cosmologists, they show why and how this hydrogen is ferried about in intergalactic space by electric currents flowing between galaxies. So these interconnecting filaments of hydrogen, neutral hydrogen that's been now found, merely shows the channels along which these currents are flowing. Because those currents tend to aggregate matter toward the filament axis over vast distances, much more powerfully than gravity does. What's more, the plasma cosmologists have explained how stars form along these filaments once they're compressed down into the spiral arms of a galaxy. So all of this has been explained, and yet it's a total mystery to astronomers.
Radio astronomy has provided evidence that electric currents can find filaments of neutral hydrogen in space.
It may be thought that the electric universe model and plasma cosmology doesn't have anything to say about neutral hydrogen. But of course, neutral hydrogen or neutral atoms in space are affected by ionized atoms and electrons that are traveling at high speed past them. Collisions and so on will draw and also some electrical interaction between these neutral atoms and the high-speed charged particles will tend to draw them together towards the central axis of the discharge. It's been many decades since the radio astronomer Gerard Vasseur, using a radio telescope, has mapped these neutral hydrogen filaments near the Sun. And he has shown that so-called clouds of neutral hydrogen are in fact merely a perspective effect where you're looking down the barrel, so to speak, of one of these hydrogen filaments, one of these electric currents flowing through space. And Gerard Vasseur has been active in looking at the plasma cosmologist's view and confirming that the expected radiation you would get from these filaments in space actually does occur. And that, to me, is a very, very powerful test of the integrity of the plasma cosmologist's model. The problem for astronomers also when it comes to finding the necessary amount of hydrogen to form stars is that they are using a gravitational theory of collapse, which requires far more neutral hydrogen than does an electric current flowing through a cloud of hydrogen, because the forces involved are so much more intense. And also, a star does not require nuclear fusion to take place at its center to be a star. So both of these things will result in stars with far less hydrogen than is required by the standard model. Earlier studies of the galactic neighborhood around NGC 6946 have revealed an extended halo of hydrogen, a feature commonly seen in spiral galaxies, which may be formed by hydrogen ejected from the disk of the galaxy by intense star formation and supernova explosions. Here again, we have this problem of the only acting mechanisms are all mechanical explosions and gravity bringing things together. Plasma cosmologists have shown that the coming together of these intergalactic current filaments to form a spiral galaxy will actually draw neutral hydrogen into a sump at the center of the galaxy, but that comes from an extended halo of neutral hydrogen, which is drawn in by forces which are greater than gravity. So these extended halos around spiral galaxies are to be expected in the plasma cosmology view. In an earlier report of magnetic spiral arms in the galaxy, NGC 6946, it was said, magnetic fields pervade spiral galaxies, at least all of those searched so far. These fields have a substantial energy density and hence could play an important role in galaxy evolution. In this report, observation of two magnetic spiral arms in NGC 6946 lying between the optical spiral arms. But it's a surprise because dynamo action is thought to be related to star formation activity, and that's concentrated within or in the leading edges of the optical spiral arms. So here we have a problem. It's said then, this organized structure probably reflects the signature of some global mechanism relating to magnetic field generation, but no current theory, in particular dynamo theory in its present form, is able to explain this phenomenon. Once again, we have the problem of magnetism being invoked to try and explain things, but the magnetism being measured doesn't match up with any of the theories. In particular, there is a substantial energy density in this magnetic field. So what's providing the energy? And also the organization of the structure being so regular also reflects that this is something critical to the formation of a spiral galaxy. Here again, we return to the plasma cosmologists, and all of this fits with their model, but you will see no mention of it in any astronomical treatise.
For continuous updates on space news from the Electric Universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.